In this video, we will be looking at how we can use if-else function in Excel. If-else function is used to test a condition, then take one action if the condition is true and another action if the condition is false. In the example shown, we have a list of students and the marks scored by them. The passing mark for the student is 200, means the student who scored less than 200 is fail, and one who scored 200 and above is pass. If column B is less than 200, column C should show fail, otherwise show as pass. The if function is written like this, equals if in bracket test the condition, then if it is true, put the true result, otherwise false result. In this example, we need to test cells in column B to see what they contain. So the formula we are using in cell C2 is equals if in bracket B2 less than 200 comma within quote fail, then comma otherwise within quote pass and close the bracket. Meaning of this is, if cell B2 is less than 200, then return fail, otherwise return the word pass. Since we are having only two status as pass and fail, we require to test only one condition, whether the mark is less than 200 or not. Let us copy the same formula till the end to get the result for all the rows. Now we will look at the second example. Here we have to check not just pass or fail conditions. We need to check the marks for multiple conditions. As you can see, we have four status as shown: fail, pass, first class and distinction. So we need at least three if statements to test this. So we should check the first condition. If it is false, then go to the second if and then third if, etc. till the condition is true. If none of the if conditions are true, then the last else will be executed. In this case, we need to extend the formula with another two if statements. We put the second if statement replacing the false result. Let us write the formula as equals if within bracket B2 less than 170 comma if it is true fail, then if it is false the second if condition starts comma if within bracket B2 less than 220 comma, if it is true, then it is pass, comma, if within bracket B2 less than 280, if this condition is true, first class, comma, if none of these three conditions are true, then it should be distinction. That means it is not less than 170, not less than 220, not less than 280. That means it is 280 and above. So that should return distinction. Now at the end, there are three opening brackets, so put three closing brackets as well. So copy the same formula till the end to get the result for all the rows. As you can see, if the mark is less than 170, it is showing as fail. The marks are between 170 and 220, it is pass. The marks are between 220 and 280, it is shown as first class. And if the marks are 280 or above, then it is shown as distinction. This technique is called nesting, since we are placing an if function inside another if function. This is also called a nested if statement. If you like this video, please click on the like button and add your comments. If you want to get more tips and tricks in Excel, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching. To get the sample Excel file used for this video, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel.